Hello there, and welcome to S.T.A.L.K.E.R. G.A.M.M.A. This is going to be in Ironman mode, on medium difficulty, on survivalist, progression difficulty. I like the harder progression difficulties simply because it slows down how quickly you can accumulate resources and such. I think that that's well and good. Gameplay difficulty, I don't want it to be on the too much harder side, because that one I think just kind of adds like a bit of tedium. I don't think it's as necessary. I think the fact that we're on one life anyway is going to be the much harder factor here. I'm going to do a bit of a basic start, just in Rookie Village, as Loner. We can pick a portrait, it doesn't much matter, it will change once we put on some suits. So I'm just gonna put on just a weird looking dude with a balaclava. If you have never seen this game before, this is a mod pack of a mod that combines three S.T.A.L.K.E.R. games together into one open world scenario, because the games all take place in a rather similar or exactly similar area. And I will be going through concepts as we come up to them. I'm going to talk through this as if you have no idea what any of this is. So I apologize to those who already know. But it'll all come through. Over here, you can see we have some points to spend that changes based on the progression difficulty that we pick. This is the inventory that you start with. There's a selection of weapons, some equipment, some meds and ammo and food. I've gone through this a few times on my own, trying to figure out what the best kind of start is. And it does feel like it is taking a TOS, because a shotgun is a very good general use weapon for both killing other S.T.A.L.K.E.R.s and for hunting any of the mutants in the zone. A piece of armor, though expensive, is at this point necessary. On a little test run that I did, 10 or 15 hours in, I still was unable to get an actual piece of armor. And that causes you so much grief, as you spend so much money every single time you make a mistake having to heal up. And a piece of armor can stop you from having to spend a lot of money. And we want to spend our points here on things that otherwise we wouldn't be able to buy. Because in this mod pack, you can't really buy equipment, or at least armors and weapons. Those are things that you have to scavenge, and you have to get better and better tools in order to make use of. I think a respirator is absolutely worth 50 points. And then from here, I feel like a Makarov is a very good addition as well. Having an option, low caliber, pretty cheap. You're going to find lots of 9mm, and it's not expensive to buy. Just a way to deal with less armored targets at range, and maybe save some of the buckshot. With that, we have 50 left over, and I think the best thing to grab would be some Yadolin here. In the interest of not having to explain everything that we're looking at, I'm just going to explain that this, combined with the bandages, heals most of our problems for now. And if you have no idea what the rest of this is, don't worry about it for now. We will go all over all of this at a later time. But for now, this feels like a very, very solid setup. I've tried going out without the armor and instead taking more supplies. And as I said, it feels really, really rough. Just how much damage you take from every single thing that ever hits you, and having no protection against the elements. I also tried taking a different weapon, but You have to kill mutants early on, and 9 mil just does not cut it, and everything else is far too expensive point-wise. If I took this Mosin, I wouldn't be able to take anything else. Could maybe take a PPSH, but I'm not too sure about the ammo and the Tommy gun using 45 ACP. So, that's all of our points. You may be wondering if we need to pick up ammo. We don't. It'll give us 20 rounds of buckshot and 50 rounds of 9mm for picking those weapons. All these other options down here don't really matter right now. We're going to be going with the base story mode. Azazel mode looks cool. Some of these things look cool, but don't worry about them. Just pick Iron Man. One life. There's ways of doing an additional feature for Iron Man where you can have like multiple lives or maybe even get some lives back. But we're just going to go with the one. I'm going to start in the rookie village because that's what I've practiced the most. And over here, you'll see that the relations of the faction that we've picked were okay with duty, clear sky, ecologist, and freedom. The reds of military, mercenary, bandit, and monolith, we are enemies with. And that's a fun feature of this, is that you can pick different factions. And I think that if we die, I want to try and just pick a different faction each time to have a completely different experience. Oh, I have to repick my items after doing that. Good. So let's begin. Now, in the video, in my editing software, I'm probably going to be upping the gamma, hilarious enough, so that people watching the video have a bit of an easier time seeing what's happening on the screen. For me, it's all well and good that it's dark, but through YouTube compression and just the general loss of recording, it'll probably be difficult to see things in certain environments, like even in this building. It might be a little bit hard on the eyes. So here we are. Our two weapons, and you can see it gave us some ammo. Let's put on the equipment. I have item animations enabled, just because I like the feeling that they give to a game. It means that putting on a piece of equipment is not instant. It takes a second. So let's go through our pieces here and why I picked them. I believe you understand the concept of the guns, so I'm not going to explain those. The piece of armor just gives us some resistances all across the board, helps us carry a little more weight, as you can see near the bottom there. A little bit of an extra move speed multiplier. Radiation resistance is fantastic. You're going to be walking into radiation a lot. Just having a little extra means that maybe you don't have to down a vodka. And see here, we've got a backpack that helps up our weight capacity. That's always nice. It's a basic tier backpack, not a gray one. The PDA and the echo detector go into these two slots. I'm going to pull out the PDA. It is our map. It has a task board. It has lots of fun information, including your relations, any contacts that you know, maybe little guides if you need some help. There's a radio if you want to listen to some music, or a history of the messages that you'll see popping up on the bottom left, as random stalkers in the zone use like a stalker version of Twitter, and we have to read everything that they put out. The map is a lot of fun. Zooming in and out and being able to check out the various areas nearby, and also with quest markers and such, which I keep enabled. I find them to be very useful. Just pressing tab once just kind of pulls up the PDA like this. Although I say tab, I switched it so that tab pulls up the PDA. I was having an error or a bug when I first started that was causing the PDA to be completely blank whenever I pulled it up, and I would have to tab back through a couple of menus before it would work. Eventually, it just worked. I'm not entirely certain why that was happening. If it's happening to you, try maybe switching out the button. I put it on tab, and now inventory's just on I, because tab used to be an inventory button as well. In the mod configuration menu, check out these key binds in here. Try and check if there's anything that's conflicting with it. When you first start out, the key binds are are pretty rough, with shift being on walk and run being on like X or something. I switched that around. And as I'm going through this house, you'll see that lootables are showing up, their little name. That's because I'm holding the loot button, which is F, I believe, by default. And it is popping up their names around me, which is nice. Can't loot everything, but what little bits that you do find are quite useful. So we're going to walk over here. This is Rookie Village. This is Cordon. The Cordon's the overall region. Rookie Village is this little village right here. Lots of friendly stalkers. All of them are loners, just like we are. When you go into the relation tab, loners are free stalkers. That was very confusing for me the first time I played this game. Go in here, past the dead rat. Possum. I mean, it's a pretty big rat. It might be a small possum. You're gonna notice there's like a box in here, nothing in it. Lockers over here, nothing in them. You're gonna find boxes and stashes out in the world, and they're going to be empty by default unless you get stash coordinates for them, in which case they will then be filled. So we talked to Sertovich. I'm not gonna really be going through dialogue. I don't really think that's the main point of this. We're just gonna grab a couple of quests from him. How do we get rich? He wants us to go meet with somebody. Who's this Strelok guy? Sounds exciting. We'll go find him. But that's not really what's important. We're going to buy some equipment, because we're missing a few things that we didn't spend our points on, and we have 5,000 rubles. We want a way to heal. We need probably a little bit more buckshot. But I'm looking at this right now, and I'm remembering, here we are. Pack of throwables. Very necessary. We don't have a lot more money. We'd only be able to afford something that was about 800 rubles or less, and we don't really see anything in here that's that amount. More Yetalin or Fentanyl for post-heals, which I'll explain in a second, cost too much. So we'll probably just make do with this, make do with the 20 buckshot. Purchase those two things. And I guess I should go over medicine in a second, but first, this pack of throwables. Very important. When you have one, just use it to open it up. And now you'll see we have some bolts and some empty cartridges. These are on 5 by default. Awesome. Pick them back up. And I'll show you why you want to do that in a bit. Second thing is medicine. Let's talk about it real quick. So there is a bleed effect. Bandages take care of the bleed effect. How do you know if you're bleeding? It's kind of rough. It's like red that pulses as an outline around your screen, or if this heart is pulsing red as well. Those are typically the times, almost any time you get hurt, you're probably gonna have a bleed. And you'll see that it also says first aid, T, A, and L with some dots next to it. T, A, and L referring to torso, arms, and limbs. H is head, if you see it. The dots are how much it does for first aid. First aid referring to the fact that your limbs can take their own damage and your overall health can take damage. If a limb takes damage, it will start to fill with red from right to left. First aid fills up some of that red, up to however much the dots imply, and it will fill up with yellow. Yellow is a temporary heal. You need a post-heal afterwards to fill the yellow with white back up to normal. And Yadalin does that for us. Does a severe dizziness. Does some other bad things to us. A med kit is also just first aid. It's not a post heal, but it does help your head, which bandages do not. And it comes with its own stronger health restoration effect. But by default, there is, and I'm going to keep saves going through here. I'm going to keep saves going through here because this is a game that can still crash. So it's important to make sure that you're keeping your saves up, even if it is an Ironman. And I forgot what I was saying about the medkit. It doesn't matter. because in this mod pack, by default, campfires slowly heal your regular health, but not your limbs up. So that's something you can kind of deal with by just waiting. Inside friendly bases or in shelters, you can save. Outside, I'm going to press the quick save button. It won't let you. Need to be near a lit campfire or in a friendly base. So that's something to keep in mind. We didn't grab a job directly from him, but if we go to the task board, refresh our tasks, in a wide area around us, it is giving us every task that people want from us. That seems pretty cool. I don't want these ones in wild territory. We want ones close by, like in Gordon, where we are. Grab that one. We could go to the Great Swamps. Let's grab a spring cleaning for bandits. In garbage. Faction Free Stalkers, Contract Killer. I'm a Free Stalker. I don't want to kill another one of another loner. Bandit Patches. I haven't actually seen that before. I haven't asked them, or they haven't asked me to kill one of my own yet. Oh, good. It re-rolled to a bandit in Cordon. Another stash in the Great Swamp. Pick up all the jobs you can, all of them. You're gonna want them. Alright, so... Cute. We're not gonna go do that yet. It's a bit too far away. Huh, and it seems this time... Where's Beard? Yeah, no, we're not gonna go get that for a while. It's one of the quests I picked up from the big man. We're gonna go do some contract killing. Isn't this spring cleaning? This is not spring cleaning? Huh, weird. Is that up in garbage? I thought for sure. Yeah, here it is. Ah, they're both on the exact same spot. Fun. Let's go do that. There is a minimap that is usually in this game, or in this mod pack. I have it turned off. If you want it on, it's perfectly fine. We are going to take a moment to go through these various houses and to pick up any of the stuff on the ground, for we are poor and in need of scavenged goods. I'm going to go through these houses. We don't have to be too careful in this area. No anomalies to hurt us. And if you don't know what an anomaly is, I will show you later. I'm sure that they're going to become a very quick part of our play. Go up this ladder. I think, yes. Oh no, this is where there's a secret stash up here, but as you can see, when we go to search it, nothing in it. Not until you have the coordinates. Until someone has told you about it. Just gonna go into every little nook and cranny, try to stuff our pockets full of whatever people have left out. There's no stealing in this game. The only time anybody is going to get on you about taking stuff is when you try to loot a corpse that is someone else's kill. In those situations, the new climbing mechanic they put in is a little awkward, but I like it. In those situations, they'll just tell you off. Just don't try to take it a second time. Nothing in here. Deck of cards in there. Suppose I should explain some of the inventory objects, but that's probably the next time we go to the trader. For now, let's just focus on collecting and then getting along with our quests. Little difficult getting out of basements. But what can you expect from a mod pack of a mod that combines three games together? It's going to be a little janky. But I promise you, this game gives an experience not really found in any others. I play a lot of Into the Radius when I'm out in the VR room. I call it that, it's just the living room that I just stuck a VR machine in. And that one's a lot of fun, but it doesn't quite hit nearly the same depth that this game does. And how could it? It's developed by one guy. And VR just isn't at the same level as the flat screen experiences. But it is so fun. A few shots. A mutant has probably wandered nearby. Not a big deal. As you can see in the bottom left, various people are typing out messages. Apparently, while they're under fire, they want to do a Twitter post. The loner kill a cat in Old Cordon, east of Rookie Village. That's probably this. Yeah, there it is. A little rough, but they seem to be fine. Middle click gives you a quick melee. I have never used that to any good effect. Some steel wool over there, that's actually a bit useful. I do my best to pace out the concepts. Ooh, two steel wool. So that it doesn't feel like everything's being shoved at you at the beginning. Alright. Let's move on. We've collected a decent amount. And as you can see, not allowed to touch the cats. There's someone else's kill. Collected a few pieces. None of them are gonna make any sense right now. That's okay. A lot of weird symbols. No problem. They don't weigh much. Let's head out. On this playthrough, I am not going to be taking any escort missions or taking on extra members in my squad with the purpose of using them as like extra help in combat or mobile storage devices. If I ever take an escort quest, it is just to escort them and immediately finish the escort quest. That is a very abusable thing that I don't wish to take part in, and really awkward, as the AI is just not very strong. But I want to be careful over here. This is quite the common spot for mutants. I'm gonna run over here and stand on this car. Just take a second, zoom in with my eyes. I'm just gonna take a second to make sure that we're okay. When I upload these videos, I'm gonna do something very similar to how I was treating Rings of Saturn for the couple episodes that I played it, where I'm going to be putting up an edited highlight version and an unedited slow-paced version. I think those videos will cater. Oh, we need to be careful. Let's get back to the car. It was quite the strong yell we just heard. Is that a bloodsucker? You see that bush just move? I'm not too happy with what's happening here. There he is. Quite a strong mutant for our first thing that we have to fight. Take a shot. Take a second shot. Good hits. Just stay on the car. Stay on the car. He can't mess with us here. Good movement, and he wouldn't be able to either. Ooh. I think he's injured. You can see the grass moving. I'm not gonna fire at that. My ammo is precious. I kind of want him to run at me again, so that he's in a bit more of a straight line. Bouncing back and forth. If this is difficult to watch in the video, then I am sorry. I'm sure that recording and rendering and uploading absolutely kills the small details like this. And there he is. Our first mutant kill. And it's a freaking bloodsucker. Insane. But some caution, some high ground, and some patience with your shots. That's all that it takes. Now, if you've never seen S.T.A.L.K.E.R. game or any content for this, you'll be noticing there are these weird things happening around in the world. These are anomalies. get near an anomaly, it'll generally pop up and tell you about it. I don't know if I didn't get close enough there. I'm not gonna mess with it much further. Yeah, not in there. Don't enter the anomalies. That's why we have these bolts. Left click to do an overhand throw, and you'll see that it burnt up when it hit a certain area. Use these bolts to figure out where the walkable path is around them. In big clusters of anomalies, you will generally find some good fortune. Normally, you'll be sent out for a quest for something specific in an anomaly cluster. Or maybe you'll just be out there looking for them because you can melt them together into better versions, which I don't know if that's specific to this mod pack or otherwise. Or you might know somebody who will buy them from you. There's a flashlight on the ground. We'll take that. It's broken, so it's no good to us as it currently is. We have some matches, so we'll light up this fire. Going to do another save here. Now this is a harsh one to break into. We need to go into there. As you can see, a bandit. As we look at him in the bottom left, our character recognizes, for some reason he knows his name. That one is like a little weird, but he recognizes what faction he belongs to and that this one is a rookie. Given that this is Iron Man, we want to be very careful with how we engage. Can't just run at them. Need to try and think about this. We have a shotgun and a Makarov. Not very high caliber. Shotgun is decent, like 35 to 40 meters. With almost no penetration on a 20 gauge, we're essentially shooting birdshot. I don't know if this is the best way to engage this area. We might want to try and circle wide around and hit them on a more blind flank. So always be on the lookout. You don't want to be ravaged by a pack of dogs or some boars. Calmly walk through here. Try to stay far enough away that we don't aggro the base. We don't want the bandits shooting at long range at us. That's definitely not something we can handle. I'm not running because I want to conserve my stamina. You never want to be caught without stamina out in the zone. Radiation, if you can hear that Geiger counter clicking. Try and avoid radiation. It builds up on you and then you have to drink alcohol or smoke cigarettes or other very specific items to get rid of it. And it can cause you a lot of pain. It can hurt your character. And always be on the lookout for almost invisible anomalies. Make sure you're not about to walk into them. They normally have visual and audio clues. Seem to be fine here. Listen. Is that footsteps I heard? Maybe not. Might have been small arms fire across the bridge. Ah, see? Look at that. We're taking fire from some bandits in Cordon, northeast of the farm. It's up that way. That's what we heard. Really helps the game feel alive when things like that happen. Over there we can see some shambling people. Zombies. The world of S.T.A.L.K.E.R. is mystical, magical a bit, and very dark and grim. Here we are. I'm gonna do a quick save, but again, probably won't matter too much. Let's do our best not to die to the first set of bandits that we fought. So let's come up to here. You can see that this is a much more blind area for us to engage in. Walls with no windows. Let's run up to this. No anomalies that we're about to step into, hopefully. Let's sneak on over. I have a little bit of an idea. We have some bandits in here. And we're supposed to eliminate a mutant threat. What if we could be a little bit smart with this? And kill two birds with one stone. A Zombies aren't too fast, they're not too smart. And they might just take a liking to us. Have them walk through the anomaly. Very funny. But we want to be able to loot them, so we shouldn't have them all explode. Oh. Well. Oh, now we're down to two. Very funny. Very funny. I don't want to use any ammo on these guys if I don't have to. Let's continue to drag them down here. Use the PDA real quick and check. The person we're hunting is on the other side of the compound. Don't seem to see almost anybody else. Hopefully I don't just create a situation where I have to shoot the bandit's wall. There are zombies behind me. They're very slow. Very, very slow. But anything worth doing is worth doing correctly. Let's drag them in. Don't see any anomalies right here. The inside. Zombies still following us. What was that I heard? Those not small arms. I'm gonna drag them over here. Don't see anybody. I really don't see anybody. Oh! Get to cover. Somebody was inside that little room that we walked past. And there they are. Ah, oh, there it is. I saw somebody. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. He can see me. Get down, get down. Solid shot on him, but not enough. Go and reload. There's one further out to the right. I don't like that. I'm gonna go back around again. Pull out the Makarov. Don't need huge caliber for humans. Here. AI has an easier time shooting through bushes than you do. Be very careful with that. Something behind me? Pull out the shotgun. Good thing I did. A solid shot. Still think there's another, though. Good shot. Take cover. There's his shadow. What a peek by him. Taking some of our health, but it's fine. The armor has kept us a little bit safe. Left arm's a little hurt. That's him again. I think he walked into that house. Ugh. Where did he go? Let's just be a little bit safe about this. Use one of our medkit uses. They come with two by default. Lean away, lean away. Hit him in the head, hit him in the head. He's down. Contract killer and spring cleaning done. You can reload a half-full mag. You're not going to lose any bullets. Let's hang out near the campfire. A little spicy there, a little spicy. A difficult place to push. But those zombies did good work for us, did they not? Awesome. We still have to clear out some mutants. It looks like those zombies were not what we were after. I'm not going to post-heal any of my limbs here, because none of them are particularly hurt enough to be too worried about. The left arm's a little badly beat up, but what really matters is our legs. If those go below half, we start taking damage when we try to run. The arms obviously shake up our aim, but I don't think that what it's at right now is a particularly strong debuff, and we don't have a lot of medicine. So we're just going to hang out here for a second. Oh no, we're actually done. Good. You can see our little yellow bar is starting to go down. Now let's begin the looting process. Sometimes they drop their weapons on the ground. Mission updated, spring cleaning? But I thought it already... What the hell? A patrol of like four or five bandits just walked in. One further out, next to the tree. I'm a little worried about the one that went over to the other side. Wonder if he's gonna pop up on the other side of my little house. Quick peek. Did he go down? No, I'm not sure. Let's go check out the other side. Be careful. I'm seeing some lightning over there. Throw a bolt. Oh, we seem fine. Electro anomaly. Hold F, pick up our bolt. We're very poor. This is a bit of a spooky push, given all the bushes. Zoom in with our eyes. Go take the corner. You hear someone kind of just coughing over there that I think is still alive. We need to find him and make sure he doesn't step back up. You. Stay down. We good? Is that all of them? How many was that? Was that four? One, two, three, four? Was that it? Blue hood. Yeah, I guess nobody did go off to the side. That was incredibly freaky. Just a random patrol of like four bandits walked in. Ah. Okay, so the looting phase. Just, for the most part, grab everything. All of this becomes useful in time. We'll go over it later. Colt 1911. I like to collect the little guns, even if they're in bad condition. I like the idea of being able to fix them up later. Grab all these pieces, grab the SKS. Plus, you kind of want to be at near max weight so that your strength skill goes up and you can keep holding more and more. Ooh, a PPA. That's very good. We're lucky that will sell for quite a lot. Ooh, this guy gave us a stash coordinate. As you can see in the bottom left there when we looted his body. That's awesome. Stashes are one of your main ways of getting more powerful in this game. This guy had a TOS like us, but this one has a 4 mag capacity, a little bit more reliability and recoil control, but for the most part it's broken down. You'll probably notice that almost everything that we've picked up so far looks pretty badly beaten up. Oh, a guitar. Oh, that's funny. We'll bring that to a nice place and set it down. Mobbing the mob, we picked up enough bandit patches. That's great. Let's do a save in case we crash. Alright, we have that guy. He's the last one to loot, I believe. Then we'll do a quick sweep of the place. Another TOS 106. You'll notice that it doesn't even have the one good part that one does. We're going to take it anyway. Ooh, some decorated jewelry box. I'll tell you why that's good later. Again, we want to try and maintain, like, a high level of loot in our packs so that our stalker gets a little bit better at walking. Go around, slash any of these little weird blue boxes you find. Or any... Let me show you the other destructible if it's around here. A file, oh, that's great. That's very good. A box that looks like that. There we go. just kind of a generic cube box. Another battery, that's lots of fun. I don't even know what that was, but I picked it up, just slurped it inside. I keep out a weapon just in case there's been like another bandit who just hasn't said anything or moved at all for some reason. Do not like going around a corner and as you peek your gun goes up. That's awful. Got a little too close to the wall. Basic sewing thread, that's always good. Pretty much everything's good. An energy drink is great. Yeah, let's go check out the rafters. Might not even need the ladder. Can do like a little bit of this. A bit too powerful that, but whatever. It's what they wanted to give us. Gotta wait for a second. Stamina is in a rough spot, but strength is going up, and that's what matters. We must become strong. Oh, did the campfire went out? It's too bad. Even just walking like this is taking stamina. Slow walking doesn't even help us. Every time we stop for stamina, I'll give an explanation of some of the things in our inventory. But it's not all just like random nonsense that I'm picking up. It all has a purpose. Okay, we're slow. So first, let's talk about the things on the bottom here. These are weapon and armor parts. As I highlight over them, you might notice other things in the inventory highlighting. Don't worry about that right now. Those just show a connection or a use in some way. All weapons are made of little parts, and all armors are made of little parts. You can see them on the bottom of their UI that pops up as I hover over them. Weapons are pretty easy to swap parts around, except for the barrel. Some other weapons might have other things that don't come out easily. But if you can find a weapon with a good barrel, and then you can find the little parts of it, maybe in other broken weapons that just happen to have a good trigger mechanism. Like, if I wanted to build up this SKS, first, I would want to find one with a good barrel, because that one doesn't come out easily. You need special tools for that. I'd want to find other bolts, gas systems, trigger mechanisms, or bolt carriers that are very specifically these ones. Some weapons share these ones, so maybe you can find like an AK that has a single mode hammer type trigger. I don't know, probably not, they're automatic, but you get what I mean. You want to try and find the other parts to replace, to build it up, and then you can get it repaired, and then maybe you'll have a functioning SKS. That's pretty much the standard way in which you try to gain power in this game. Armors are a little bit trickier. You can't really swap out the pieces in this. You need specific toolkits. We'll be getting to that later, hopefully. Jerry can. It's a bit heavy, but whatever. Let's get in here. Some boxes in here. Need to be careful. We are right next to that. And then that last one, I was able to pick up all the rest. So as you're going through, you're just trying to pick up little pieces to see if you can eventually build up a new piece of equipment. Most of this, though, is garbage, and is completely useless even in its constituent parts. But I want to try and bring stuff back to donate to the local traders. They won't purchase it, but if I can donate it enough, I might be able to get them to the next tier without having to complete as many tasks. I'm gonna take from this zombie here. He has some rubles. I don't know how many rubles, just an amount. And yeah, that. I guess this is good when you're about to go into radiation. Well, that's nice. A little bit of a long animation for when you're looting a mutant. Where'd that second zombie go? It led two into here. A grooming kit underneath, that's nice. That is used for deconstructing clothing and such. So it's good to have a couple of those. They're fairly cheap as well. So don't worry about trying to keep its usability and only deconstruct some or others. Very good part of how we spent our points in the beginning is the fact that we have a good piece of armor. Could very easily be running around naked, and we would have died in that last engagement if that was the case. Shotgun to our north. I wonder what that's about. Just gonna stand next to this campfire for a second, let it heal up our health bar a little bit. I'm gonna pull out my gun. Most likely those are other loners like us. As you can see here, their stats are pretty bad, but that's because the stats on armor goes down as they get degraded. If you hold left control, you'll notice these little bars fill up, because even mine's degraded just a little bit. And when you hold left control, you can see what they're like at their best. Black leather jacket is not too inspiring. You can tear off the patch, get the bandit patch off of it. That also doubles as being a way to wear another faction's outfit without pissing off your own faction. Hold control on this, and this gas mask is better than our headpiece in every way, so we want to save this. It only needs a piece of Sith, as it says there, this synthetic thread. Synthetic cloth, I believe. These are cloth sheets, so we don't have the things for it yet, and even if we did, it would take a light armor repair kit to be able to do anything to it. But that's nice that we found one that at least has one good piece. It's a definite upgrade when we can get to it. This balaclava is nice, I guess, for chemical resistance, but we like the radiation resistance of ours. You know, we'll be keeping it. PDA. We took off of a body. Right click, view. It puts it in your PDA slot and brings it out. Then a left click or right click to look in closer. Just kind of click through these little bits of lore if you want to read them. Sometimes they can have stash locations, which is always a lot of fun. Put ours back. Take the batteries out of it. Don't deconstruct it. Save those PDAs. That man that we got some missions from and did some trading with in the beginning will pay you handsomely for PDAs. Sometimes they'll even have information on them that you weren't able to get. Sometimes it's not worth much. They'll give you like 900 rubles or so, but hey, that's 900 more than you had before. Given how heavy we are already, we might want to go off to the place that I like to call home to drop some stuff off. And that we're full of a lot of garbage. Like a lot of garbage. We have enough money for us to buy a little pack. And I will show you what, oh, hey, there he is. A free bandage and some ripples. What the base building is like. Not that you build a base, but you can set down little storage and little display racks. It's a lot of fun. We're not near a campfire, that makes sense. Accidentally pulled out my echo detector. Don't worry about that for now. We'll go over what it is later. So, as you can see, we're very slow and we're very heavy, so we want to be careful here. Not do a lot of sprinting. Just do some traveling. And our strength will be going up as we do it. It says that it levels up through just traveling at a higher weight. I wonder if that means that maybe just running causes you to travel faster, so you gain the XP faster. Difficult to tell. Nah, we'll mess with mutants when we're not slow. Bit of a death sentence not being able to run. And you might have some mutants to deal with. And I think there are some bandits over there. Stand next to this campfire for a second. Do another save. Definitely a holdover habit from not playing Iron Man, but I think it's still probably a good habit. It's only crashed once on me in the past 20-odd hours, but that is still a crash. I'm not seeing anything over there. I know it's a little cheap using the built-in zoom option, but I think that's fine. Supposedly there's a bandit over there, or that's the guy we gotta turn it into. Nope, that's a bandit. Oh, look at our arms. A little bit of sway from the damage that it's taken. We don't want to mess with them. We're gonna go around. We just want to go to the farm, set down some of our stuff, donate what's not useful. Frozen this guy. They don't really signify anything, not right now. You can shoot them down and they'll have some rubles, maybe some bullet casings. A lot of the time they have a blunt. That's I'm not quite certain. Might be a Russian thing. Russian crows like to get high. A drink of water while we're waiting. Now down here, you'll see that we have these like little items near the bottom that aren't quite weapon parts, but they're not quite ammo pieces either. And as you can see, yes, you can put together pieces of ammo once we get a gunsmith kit. That's very fun. These are junk items that you take apart for their constituent pieces. They're used as repair bonuses. When you're repairing things, you can select the piece of steel wool. It'll consume it, but give a higher repair. They're used to craft things, or if they have this ruble symbol, they're just there to sell. Very good to pick up little pieces of junk. I like coming up here because on the other side, you can jump over this little fence and you don't have to go under. But this side, you have to go under the bridge. We should be fine. I don't see any immediate problems. Am I hearing them? No, I think I'm hearing the electro near me. You can see some sparks over there and some distortion. Don't touch that. I'll throw a bolt so you can see it. And there we go. I don't like the fact that we're downhill of possible mutants, but we're quite close to a safe spot. If need be, I can climb on top of that truck and be pretty safe. Although I've been hit by weirder, janky attacks by dogs and such before. You never, never quite know how close to death you are in this game. You can be perfectly fine on the top of your game. You've just turned in missions, you're doing great, you've bought ammo, and all it takes is you walk near a bad spot of visibility on a hill, you're low on stamina, and three dogs just hit you without you even knowing that they were there. And you're dead. That's all it can take. That's especially how it feels when you don't have any armor. Bit more survivable with this now. Don't have to use nearly so many meds. And that's like, I think I'm hearing my own footsteps. That's like the biggest part about having armor. Every time you get hit, you're spending rubles. It's like it's deducting it straight from your account. You get hit, there's another 2k gone, depending on the damage that it does. Do you have to do a post heal? Do you have to stop a bleed? Like what? Like how much damage that attack did to you really, really threatens your ability to progress and to, like, be able to do things in this game. So having a piece of armor is worth so much more. Like, you could argue, oh, well, why have the armor when you could just use the points to buy more meds? Well, because it's every single time you get hit, you're gonna have to use more meds. Every single time you enter a place with more radiation and you have no radiation protection. But with the armor, it takes away so much of that problem that you're going to have. Instead of losing your legs the moment a cat attacks you, you get to have an extra little piece of movement. Ah, picked up the free jerry can there. Let's drop that on the ground real quick. We'll come right back out for that. It's very important. As we're walking into here, anything else that I haven't really gone over? I guess, you get what the ammo pieces are. You can smith your own ammo. Basic food and water. Alcohol and cigarettes help you reduce your radiation. But they can also, like, make you more tired, or they can hurt you. Or they can take away some of your satiation level, making you need to eat more, drink more regular water. You can pick up pieces from mutants and you can cook them with cooking kits. If you cook them in water, they have a bit of radiation on them. If you can cook them in alcohol, they actually come out rather purified. Very good. Over here, you see the various medicines, all of them having rather specific effects. Like, if you really need to make sure that you're not going to be taking bleeding damage for the next, you know, 7 or so minutes. Or if you really want to make sure that, what is this, you have some more radiation protection going into something. You can play guitar. If you find a harmonica, you can play that. Yeah, I would like to stop playing guitar now. I think you're locked into this once you start it. It's nice. We're gonna be collecting things that say, like, repair kits, sewing kits, gun lubes, things like that. Nail files and, or not nail files, but regular files and such. These things help maintain your equipment. They maintain your individual gun parts, or the guns themselves, or your armor. These are important to have a lot of. Matches for starting up campfires, batteries, of course, the wallet just holds your rubles up here. Personal journal. This, I believe, is just something that we sell to somebody. Or it can be used, you see it has a repair bonus under properties, it's another one of those things that can be used to repair something else. And here we are, what I'm going to call home. I'm gonna walk over to this guy. He's another vendor like the other one, although he doesn't sell as many meds. But we're gonna buy. Gonna buy this little pack from him for 300 rubles, not a lot. Gonna bring that over here. Gonna right click, place item. It's gonna bring up this little weird green boy. Gonna place it right about at the edge of this. I like this little spot. We're gonna be able to put away the various things that we found out there. That we want to keep around. And nobody's gonna mess with this. You could use the various stash locations that are around here, but the moment that stash location gets rolled for something that you can loot, all of your stuff in it is gone. So I wouldn't recommend it. And I think if you put it on the ground, other stalkers will consume it, so don't let them do that. Away all of this. Keep the ones that are specifically for selling, some cards and some jewelry. Throw in all of this ammo that isn't what we use. Extra meat. Don't need that much alcohol laying around. We got a free sparkling water from something. Put away these extra meds that are a bit specific. We don't need that. There's extra bandages. Throw in the nail file. Only need one grooming kit on us. Don't need these on us. All right. Awesome. Look at that. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to take these extra just awful guns. The Makarov and the Taz. We don't need a second of. I'll keep these other ones around. It's just nice to have a collection. We're going to take the jacket and the balaclava. Balaclava does have a good piece of dirt on it, so we're actually going to disassemble that. We're going to go back into here. We're going to take out the pieces that are so low percentage that they're never going to be useful. Like anything under 30 that's for armor, I don't think that's ever going to be useful for us. 35 is barely breaking it. 32. Got this other red one. You're okay. For gun pieces, it's like you want 50 to 60. I think 60% is probably more so what you would want, because most things won't repair under 60, so it's probably a mistake to grab anything that's not above 60. But for armor pieces, it's a little different, because armor pieces change the overall condition of the armor itself. So even if you have an awful piece of armor, an awful one of these, it might still be better than what it has, so it would benefit you to put that in there. The Dura away. Let's go over to this guy. Let's donate these extra things to him. Donate these bits as well. You can sell gun parts for pittance to the mechanic, but I'm not going to do that. I want this guy to upgrade his supply level, which also comes from just doing, like, quests for the loners. Although this guy never gives out quests. So it's a little weird. I don't know about this guy. Just doing this seems to do good stuff for me. There we go. And he doesn't take the PDA. And for some reason, when you're in the trading window, it looks like it's full of battery. It is not. We took that battery out. Okay. So that's all well and good. This guy over here has a task for you. He wants you to get him a basic tool set. That is the first major upgrade. We also want a basic tool set. Thankfully, if you give one to him, you can make use of his workbench over there, and it will act as if you have that, so that's nice. But if we can find one for ourselves as well, that would be great, because that is a workbench on the go. You check his equipment, you see he has a handgun repair kit. That's the first step to being able to actually maintain and replace parts within handguns. As you can see, if we go to the details on this, it wants a handgun repair kit. It also could take a universal. Universals are much more expensive, though. Check the the Colt 1911 we have over here, also a handgun repair kit. Check the Scorpion, it even wants a handgun repair kit, so that's kind of cool. It's another 9x18, but it's fully auto. That would, for the most part, be an upgrade over our Makarov. But it costs a lot of money. 13,000. We don't have that kind of scratch right now, and even if we did, there are other things that we want. Lots of basic pieces of equipment in here for maintaining your stuff. Little packets that you can read to unlock crafting options for various backpacks. And then some basic pieces for like double barrel shotguns, polyester fabrics. So we're gonna be keeping an eye on him. Upgrading this guy is another one of our key pieces of advancement. Okay, have the PDA on us. We don't really need anything else on us that we had put away. Close down that task list. We're gonna go over here. Take care of the mutants that we left behind. We're gonna take care of the bandits. We're gonna go back and turn in all of our quests and get a bunch of money, and we're gonna purchase some good things. Guy's a little thirsty. We're gonna let that be for now. Let's do another save. Or let's do a proper save. So first things first, I think we should probably take care of the bandits, as they're a bit more dangerous than the mutants. In some ways. Our guns haven't taken that much of a beating yet, so we're not too concerned about maintaining them. The mechanic in there can repair them for a very small price. If you're only repairing like 10% of a rather low tier gun, he's not gonna make you pay all that much.
It just activated that.
I guess sometimes I can just activate, but normally it's because something passed through it. Bit odd. We're gonna hug the right side over here. So it'll be like 900 rubles or so to get the TOS back up, but all that does is it maintains the overall condition of the weapon. It does not maintain the individual parts. Weapons and armor function differently in that manner. The individual parts are going to need specific cleaning kits, which are a bit cheaper and a bit easier to find than the full-on repair kits. So it shouldn't be a huge deal.
I think I see like a dead mutant over there.
That thing's just going off over and over again. Is my bolt sitting there just causing it infinite misery? Be kind of funny. There's one. No! It's a Freedom member. I thought I saw a bandit over here. Maybe the Freedom guy came in and wiped him out? Freedom's good for us. You can see in the bottom left it's like a green wolf patch or something. I don't think Freedom and Bandits, Freedom and Bandits, do they like each other? Freedom? Bandit, oh, they do. Okay, so he wouldn't really assist me if I picked a fight with the bandits in here, but he won't blame me either. Give me a little cheeky zoom in. I think my guy is right there. is. I don't like the distance I'm at. But I don't want to enter this mill either. It's gonna be a very anomaly heavy mill. Although it looks clear right now. He's cool. He's cool. Need to be careful of that anomaly. It doesn't look like it's at the corner. It's a bit further out. They're not gonna snitch. He's cool. It's just him. There he is. We're all good. They can walk through. Stalkers don't trigger anomalies. It's a little unfortunate to see things like that, but I get it. A Thompson with a dirty trigger mechanism. We'll take it. The donation. Otherwise, if we weren't donating, just take the mechanism out by field stripping and removing trigger mechanism. We'll see if any of these guys have any tasks for us. You guys need anything? Smoked salmon. Nope. We'll move on. The mutant's over there. I don't think having the weapon out, like, changes your run speed or your stamina usage, so feel free to keep yourself safe. Let's traverse the zone. Over here and do a save. In front of us, a little to the right, is the anomaly that killed like three or four zombies. It was pretty funny. I want to be careful about approaching a mutant area from a blind spot, like bushes and cresting a hill. What is that? What is that? Is that like the top of dog heads or something? Yeah, it's about in front of us. I thought for sure it had crashed. Getting a little stuttery. A lot of anomalies in this area. Could be useful. A little dangerous trying to actually use anomalies against animals, though. They tend to steer around them. Sometimes you can trick them into it. I think... okay, I think we're good. Whatever the last mutant was stepped into the anomaly and died. What are you guys? Bandits must have killed some dogs. Some cats. Body's too decayed. Alright, let's head back over to Rookie Village and turn in these little things of ours. Spring cleaning? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Another bandit came in. Here's some shots over there that might be from Rookie Village. Oh, sometimes when you put, like, your inventory or your PDA away, it'll kind of distort your screen. Just bring up the PDA again and put it away and it should fix it. Darn, should we go get those last bandits at the top of the road? It's so far away. It's too bad that's another mission we can't turn in. Spring cleaning turned into just like kill every single bandit on the map apparently. Unless that's the guy we need to turn it into. Maybe he went on patrol to the top of the map. Keep the shotgun out. You never know what you're gonna find. A lot of automatic fire. Maybe just like a cat wandered too close to the village. Radiation anomaly? I don't like seeing that pop up. I would rather not step into that. Whenever the screen goes fuzzy, it's trying to tell you that you're close to some radiations, like hotspot. The anomaly on the bridge to my right. Some dead things around here. Who are you? That's an ecologist. This is a dead ecologist. They were beset upon by dogs? I don't wish to be rude, but like, one man's death is another man's. Oh, he died so long ago, apparently. That's too bad. It was a professional, too. That would have been good loot if I had gotten here earlier. Any others take a fall? I am a true rat. I am a scavenger. Not willing to kill them myself, but I will take advantage of any unfortunate accidents that happen in this zone. No, they seem fine. Oh well, move on. See if they have any work for me. Fracture hand and three piece. Sharpening stone set. Nope. End of no. Screen might be going fuzzy once in a while, maybe because of my hurt hand. Maybe it's just some pain for my guy. Maybe because he's hungry and thirsty. I don't think that should be a reason for your vision to go fuzzy, but. Check the task board real quick. Maybe there's something. Somebody's like, oh, I need one plastic jar. Turn in the quest to these fine gentlemen. One of them was from, like, this guy? You? Nope. I love your striker, though. That's sick. No, it is both of them. You. Job's done. Could be either. Did spring cleaning just proc? God damn it. You walked a bit closer. The sooner you get an RF receiver, the sooner we'll help out. That's something for later. When it's something we actually have to worry about. We'll get into it. Ask him about paid stashes. For 6,500 rubles, he'll tell us about a stash. That's pretty important. But right now, we're here for two things. We want some binoculars and a headlamp. Buy those bad boys. 8,000 left over. We're still doing good on ammo. Maybe a little 9mm. Got another 15 rounds. Am I an idiot? Combine? Excuse me? My brain. Tiny. These are AP rounds. I buy those. Whoops. Tiny indeed. I spent 1,800 on that. Whoops. Alright, nothing else though that really matters right now. I don't want to donate to him. We're gonna be doing so many missions for him that doesn't really matter. Maybe some more medicine though. Grab another med kit. Some more fentanyl. Can't afford... Nope, I can afford some Yadlin. Great, great, great. Good, good, good. Buy some of that as well. Down to 76 rubles. Binoculars. And a headlamp. Awesome. Awesome, awesome. It's looking good. It's looking very good. Oh, the PDA. I have some information to sell. Found a PDA. Here. $400. Not much. But still, better than nothing. Sometimes you can get a real treat out of that. Check the PDA again. Check if anybody's got some refreshed tasks for us. A mutant in cordon south of the train tunnel. Easy. Might even get done without us. Besides, that's close to that spring cleaning, isn't it? Oh, that's south of the train tunnel? I don't feel like... Oh, I suppose that's the train tunnel. Okay, fair enough. Alright.